I'm Chandramohan, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, Mallareddy Institute of Engineering and Technology. Today in my session, I'm going to explain evaluation of triple integrals. Okay, how to evaluate the triple integrals. Now, I'll discuss some examples so that you can understand clearly. So the question is integral 0 to 1, integral 1 to 2, integral 2 to 3, xyz, dx, dy, dz. This is a question. Evaluate integral 1 to 2, sorry, integral 0 to 1, integral 1 to 2, 2 to 3, xyz, dx, dy, dz. Here the limits are constant. If the limits of a integral are constant, we can follow any order of the integration. Means the order of the integration is immaterial. Okay. Means now here you can integrate with respect to x first or with respect to y first or with respect to z first. Means you can follow any order. Okay. So now here I'm going to integrate, same order I'm taking. I'm going to integrate with respect to x first, then y, then z. It's not compulsory to you can follow the same order. Okay, you can follow any order because the limits are constant. So now I'm integrating with respect to x first, then y, then z. Okay, first I'm writing the limits. X, y, z, na? First you can take z limits. Z equals to 0 to 1. Then y limits are y equals to 1 to 2. Then x limits are x equals to 2 to 3. Right? So I'm integrating with respect to x first. Right? Then with respect to y. Okay. Then we are going to integrate with respect to z, z dz. Now that is integral z equals to 0 to 1. What is integration of x? X square by 2. The y limits also we have, right? What are the y limits here? Y equals to 1 to 2. Then integration of x is what? X square by 2. The limits are 2 to 3. Okay. Y dy, then z dz. Now we can substitute upper limit minus lower limit, right? That is z equals to 0 to 1, y equals to 1 to 2, right? So now x square by 2, right? X is replaced by 3, upper limit minus lower limit, x is replaced by 2. That is 3 square by 2 minus 2 square by 2. 3 square by 2 nothing but what? 9 by 2 minus 3 square by 2. 9 by 2, 2 square by 2. That is 4 by 2. Upper limit minus lower limit into y dy into z dz. Now, like fractions, right? 9 minus 4 is 5. So, 5 by 2. It is a constant. I'm writing outside of integration. Then z equals to 0 to 1. Now y equals to 1 to 2. Right? So y dy into z dz. Yeah, this is 5 by 2 into integration of z equals to 0 to 1. Integration of y is what? Y square by 2. What are the y limits here? Y limits are 1 to 2 into z dz. Okay, this I will continue in the next page. Now here we have this is, yeah, 5 by 2. Okay, yeah, this is we have 5 by 2 into integral z equals to 0 to 1. We can replace upper limit minus lower limit, right? Y is replaced by 2 minus y is replaced by 1. 2 square by 2 minus 1 square by 2. That is upper limit 2, no? 2 square by 2. That is 4 by 2 minus 1 square by 2. That is 1 by 2 into z dz. Okay. 4 minus 1 is what? 3. 4 minus 1 is what? 3. 3 by 2. So 5 by 2. Here we have 5 by 2. This is into 3 by 2. Integral z equals to 0 to 1 z dz. Now this is we can write 5 3 is 15, 15 by 4. Again, integration of z is what? Z square by 2. The limits are 0 to 1. Okay, now 15 by 4 into upper limit is what? 1, right? 1 square is 1. 1 by 2 minus 0. So that is 15 by 4 into 1 by 2 minus 0 is what? 1 by 2. 15 by 4 into 1 by 2. What's the answer? That is, you'll get 15 by 8. 15 by 8 is the required answer. This is the integral value. Okay, is it clear? So the integral x 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, x, y, z, dx, dy, dz. So what is the value we got it? 15 by 8. Okay, now I'll take one more example and I'll explain. Yeah, the question is, evaluate integral 0 to 1, integral 1 minus x, integral 0 to 1 minus x minus y, dx, dy, dz. So first we have to fix the limits, right? Here I have the limits in terms of x and y. X, y limits I am fixing for the variable z. Z equals to 0 to 1 minus x minus y. Again, I have x limits, right? So that I am fixing for y. Y equals to 0 to 1 minus x and remaining 0 to 1, the constant limit I am fixing for x. Is it clear? XY limits I am fixing for z and x limits I am fixing for y. Remaining constant limits I am fixing for x. Okay. Now here z is a function of, z limits are in terms of x and y, right? Z is a function of xy. Means z limits are in terms of x and y. That's what we can integrate with respect to z. Then the complete problem convert in terms of x and y. Now we can integrate with respect to y. Y limits are in terms of x. So wherever you have y, y is replaced by x. Then the complete problem convert in terms of x. Now finally, if I integrate with respect to x, x limits are constant. I'll get some magnitude, some value, numerical value, I'll get it. So here first I'm trying to integrate with respect to z first. First I'm writing integral x equals to 0 to 1. Integral y equals to 0 to 1 minus x. Integral z equals to 0 to 1 minus x minus y. We are integrating with respect to z, then with respect to y, then with respect to x. What is integration of dz? Z. Integral x equals to 0 to 1. Integral y equals to 0 to 1 minus x. What is integration of dz? Z. Now z is replaced by upper limit minus lower limit. What is upper limit here? 1 minus x minus y minus 0. There is no need to write. So 1 minus x minus y into I have dy. Dy into dx. I think this is clear, right? So integration of dz is z. Z is replaced by upper limit minus lower limit. What is upper limit here? 1 minus x minus y minus, what is the lower limit? 0. 0, no need to write. That's what I'm writing. 1 minus x minus y into dy. Again, finally, it is dx. Now, x equals to 0 to 1 and y equals to 0 to 1 minus x. Here, I'm dy, right? I'm integrating with respect to y. So, 1 is constant. X is also, we can fix, right? So 1 minus x I'm treating as constant, it is one term because I'm integrating with respect to y. So 1 minus x into integration of dy is what? Y. So I'll get 1 minus x into y minus integration of y is what? Y square by 2. Right? So here we are integrating, no need to write the limits. So here I'm integrating. See, 1 minus x I'm treating as, here I am integrating directly, so no need to write the integration. Integral y equals to 0 to 1 minus x, 1 minus x minus y dy. We are integrating with respect to y, right? So 1 minus x I am treating as constant, and which is one term. 1 minus x into integration of dy is what? Y. 1 minus x into integration of dy is y minus integration of y is what? Y square by 2. Now here we can write the limits, y limits. 0 to 1 minus x into dx, right? Now this is x equals to 0 to 1. Wherever you have y, y is replaced by upper limit 1 minus x, lower limit 0. 0 no need to replace. 1 minus x into again what is y? 1 minus x. 1 minus x into 1 minus x is what? 1 minus x whole square minus y is replaced by 1 minus x. So again 1 minus x whole square by 2 whole x. Is it clear? Y is replaced by 1 minus x, right? 1 minus x into 1 minus x is 1 minus x whole square minus 1 minus x whole square by 2 dx. Now, if I take 1 minus x whole square is outside, not outside, 1 minus x whole square, if I take common, 1 minus 1 by 2, 1 minus 1 by 2 is what? 1 by 2. I am taking 1 minus x whole square is common in these two terms. If I take 1 minus x whole square is common in these two terms, 1 minus 1 by 2, 1 minus 1 by 2 is what? 1 by 2, 1 minus x whole square into 1 by 2. The 1 by 2 I am writing outside of integration, and integral x equals to 0 to 1, you will get 1 minus x whole square into dx. Okay, now, I'll continue in the next page. We have 1 by 2 into this whole thing I am treating as x. What is integration of x? This is 1 minus x I am treating as some x. Integration of x square is what? X power 3 by 3. That we can write 1 minus x whole power 3 by 3. Again, integration of 1 minus x is what? Minus 1 by minus 1. What are the limits here? 0 to 1. I'll repeat. Just the 1 minus x you can treat as some x. What is integration of x square? X power 3 by 3. Again, integration of what is 1 minus x? Minus 1 by minus 1. Limits are 0 to 1. This is minus 1 by 6. This is minus 3, na? Minus 1 by 6. 1 minus x whole power 3. The limits are 0 to 1. Okay. That is minus 1 by 6. If I replace upper limit, 1 minus 1 is what? 0 minus x is 0. 1 minus 0 is what? 1. 1 cube is what? 1. So what's the value you're getting? 1 by 6 into 0 minus 1 is what? Minus 1. I'll get 1 by 6. Yeah, 1 by 6 is the required answer. Okay. Yeah, this is, I'll just repeat. If I have x, y limits that you can fix for z. Again, x limits I'm fixing for y. Again, constant limits I'm fixing for x. Like that we can proceed. Okay. Now, I'll explain one problem in polar coordinates. Then you can understand about triple integrals. You'll get some idea. Okay. Now, move on to some polar coordinates problem. Yeah, this is fine. We have limits integral 0 to pi by 2, integral 0 to a sin theta, integral 0 to a square minus r square by 2 r dz dr d theta, right? So now this is r limits I'm fixing for z equals to 0 to a square minus r square by 2. Again, theta limits I'm fixing for r. Okay, now 0 to pi by 2 I'm fixing for theta. Like that I'm fixing the limits. First, r limits I'm fixing for z equals 0 to a square minus r square by 2. Again, theta limits I'm fixing for r. Again, finally, this is 0 to pi by 2 I'm fixing for theta. So in these type of problems, try to integrate first with respect to z, then with respect to r, then with respect to theta. Maximum number of problems. Try to integrate with respect to z first, then r, then theta. Okay. Now, theta equals to 0 to pi by 2. Then r equals to 0 to a sin theta. Now, z equals to 0 to a square minus r square by 2 dz into r dr, this is d theta. Fine. Now, yeah, first we're integrating with respect to z, right? What is integration of dz? Integration of dz is what? Z. So that I'm writing theta equals to 0 to pi by 2, r equals to 0 to a sin theta, देन वी हैव इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ dz इज वॉट z अगेन अपर लिमिट माइनस लोअर लिमिट अपर लिमिट इज ए स्क्वेयर माइनस आर स्क्वेयर बाई टू लोअर लिमिट जीरो ओके इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ dz इज वॉट z z इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय अपर लिमिट माइनस लोअर लिमिट वॉट इज अपर लिमिट हियर ए स्क्वेयर माइनस आर स्क्वेयर बाई टू माइनस लोअर लिमिट जीरो नो नीड टू राइट इन टू आर डी आर हियर वी हैव डी टीटा राइट सो न दैट इज टीटा इक्वल्स टू जीरो टू फाइव बाई टू राइट नाउ दिस इज आर इक्वल्स टू जीरो टू ए साइन टीटा राइट मल्टीप्लाइंग विथ आर ए स्क्वेयर आर माइनस आर पावर थ्री दिस वन बाई टू कैन राइट आउट साइड राइट इट्स ईजी देन ए स्क्वेयर आर आर पावर थ्री वी आर इंटीग्रेटिंग विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू आर देन थीटा राइट सो दैट इक्वल्स टू वन बाय टू इंटू इंटीग्रल थीटा इक्वल्स टू जीरो टू पाई बाय टू राइट नाउ नाउ ए स्क्वेयर इंटू इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ आर इज वॉट आर स्क्वेयर बाय टू माइनस इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ आर पावर थ्री इज वॉट आर पावर 4 by 4, the limits are 0 to a sin theta d theta. Is it clear? I think so, right? A square into integration of r is what? R square by 2 minus integration of r power 3 is what? R power 4 by 4, the limits are 0 to a sin theta d theta. Now we can replace upper limit minus lower limit. Wherever you have r, r is replaced by a sin theta minus 0. Upper limit minus lower limit, right? So 1 by 2 into theta equals to 0 to pi by 2 a square into r is replaced by a sin theta whole square that is a square sin square theta a square into a square sin square theta is what a power 4 sin square theta by 2 minus r is replaced by a sin theta whole power 4 that is a power 4 sin to the power of 4 theta by 4 whole d theta right now yeah this is I want to continue the next page yeah this is first I will try to write separately this integral value yeah I'm writing separately then this is a power 4 by 2, 1 by 2, right? I'll get a power 4 by 4 integral theta equals to 0 to pi by 2 sin square theta d theta c z minus a power 4 by 2 fourths are 8. A power 4 by 8 integral theta equals to 0 to pi by 2 sin to the power of 4 theta d theta already you studied intermediate we have a formula right that is we have sin to the power of n theta if n is even okay we have a formula that all right yeah since integral theta equals to 0 to pi by 2 I'm writing the formula integral 0 to pi by 2 sin to the power of n theta d theta if n is even we have a formula right n minus 1 by n into n minus 3 by n minus 2 up to so on after getting 1 by 2 you have to multiply with pi by 2 this is the formula right now I'm applying the same formula here a to the power of 4 by 4 sin square theta n is 2 right 2 minus 1 is what 1 1 by 2. I got directly 1 by 2. 1 by 2 which is multiplied by directly pi by 2. Minus a power 4 by 8. What is n? Sin to the power of 4 theta d theta. N is 4, right? 4 minus 1 is what? 3. 3 by 4. 4 minus 3 is what? 1. 4 minus 2? 2. So 1 by 2. Again you got 1 by 2 which is multiplied by pi by 2. This we have to simplify. Pi a to the power of 4 by 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16 minus this is 3 pi a to the power of 4 by 4 8 is 32, 32 to the 64, 64 to the 128. Okay. Now LCM is 128. Yeah, this is 16, right? 4, 4, 16 means 16, 8 is 128. You'll get 8 pi, 16, 8 is 128 now. 8 pi a power 4 minus 3 pi a power 4 by 128. 8 pi a power 4 minus 3 pi a power 4, that is 5 pi a power 4 by 128. This is the required value. Friends, this is a way to find evolution of triple integral. Thank you.